Well, this is once again the disembodied voice of Dan St.Yves, and I'm here today with the cast of the Marvelous Wonderettes. So we're going to take a few minutes right now and just go around, and if you could just let me know who you are and what role you play in this particular show.
So my name is Melanie McNinley, and I play Betty Jean, or BJ, in the show.
Hi, I'm Laura Caswell, and I play Susie Simpson.
And I'm Melanie Piatoka, and I play Cindy Lou Huffington.
I am Amber Bissonette, and I am the swing for the show.
I have already had a chance to see the show, and it's sort of based on music that's 50, 60 years old, and yet you've got three generations of people in the audience. How do you manage to get that to resonate with everybody in there?
Well, I feel like all the characters are, although they are really heightened characters, they are approached with a lot of honesty. And I think that'll get you every time.
And humor. Everybody loves to laugh, and I think there's a moment to laugh at every one of these girls as well.
And the songs help tell the story as well. We use them as a vehicle to move the plot along. Each song is chosen for each character, and it speaks to many generations. So if you didn't grow up with the music, you grew up listening to it, or your parents were playing it.
You all get to play really strong characters. It's one of those rare occasions where everybody gets a chance to have a character that's believable, and in your cases, you all really bring your characters to life. Was anything there kind of different or fun for you? Is acting challenges?
I guess. I hope I'm not like Susie. I hope. I mean, I hope I'm a kind individual like her, but she's slightly or very distracted, and she likes gum, and she likes shiny things, and all those. So it's fun to find that part of yourself, the goofy part, the oblivious part, and that joy. So that's fun. It's because even if you're having a bad day, Susie never has a bad day.
No. Yeah, with BJ, she just has so much energy, and she kind of doesn't have a filter, so she just says whatever she's thinking, and that's what makes her endearing. She's honest, and I think for me, it's been a real challenge just playing with so much intensity all the time. But I'm really discovering that I like it. It's fun.
Well, speaking of intensity, there's a particular, now is that early in the second act or towards the end where You're very physical in one particular song, and I'm wondering if that's where Amber, who is the stand-in for all of the characters, is waiting for a trip to the chiropractor to take poor Betty Jean out for the rest of the run.
No, I think doing the cartwheel in high heels in a prom dress to the chiropractor.
Oh my gosh, there are some memorable moments in this show. I'm going to suggest that, as I mentioned earlier, most of the songs are 50 to 60 years old. None of you look like you may have been around when those were originally released. Was it tough connecting to stuff that old?
I feel like I knew most of the songs. My mom played a lot of that music.
Yeah. So whether family played it or they're in movies, I mean, they're all classic.
Timeless. They're classic pieces, and because we use them in the show as vehicles to express ourselves, you know, it speaks to you if you're singing it as a character, and it's helping your story being told. So that's how I connect it to my songs.
I will say at the same time, I think an interesting challenge for all of us to find a journey that perhaps was not intended in the original writing of the song, and that's part of the joy of this show is figuring out how to do that. It's
very good. So how do you prepare for being in the wings waiting for that moment to jump in on a moment's notice?
You just sit back and relax and breathe and learn the show as one big picture. And eventually you get to learn where you need to fit in depending on what character you are, and what harmony is missing. And it's learning the show as one big puzzle. Yeah, it's a challenge.
Well, something I've had some fun with in a recent interview was make this an actor's choice, and we'll go one by one. Maybe we'll start over on your side this time. And it can be this show or any show in your career to date. What's either the most embarrassing thing that's ever happened to you on stage or the most gratifying moment on stage?
The most embarrassing was falling, practically just walking, right behind Patricia Zentilli, who is belting a D sharp in the middle of a song, and I just fell right behind her. It was glorious. You were there. That was Dirty Rotten Scoundrels.
Oh my gosh.
And the gratifying moment, that's a tough one. There's been a lot. I had a seeing eye dog try to rescue me when I was playing Anita in the West Side Story a number of years ago. But that was pretty awesome.
I would say the most embarrassing thing is probably falling once again. Although that was due to a limbo stick that kept getting lower and lower every night. And one night I just wasn't up to that challenge. And more embarrassing than falling on my back was probably the way I decided to get up, downward dog style, with my big yellow bathing suit bum in the air and my skirt over my head. So that would be the most embarrassing. I didn't think I could walk back on stage 2 seconds later after I did my quick change, but I did, and the show went on, and that's how it goes. And gratifying, I don't know, that's too difficult. I don't have one.
Oh. Well, I am clumsy, so I've had quite a few. I've had a few, like, wardrobe malfunctions, if you will. Those have been pretty fun. One funny story from recently was playing the Wicked Witch of the West, and there was a trap door that would make me sink into the ground, and one day it didn't go. So that was a little embarrassing, because you're just like, and just sort of like literally like dove into the wing. That was a little odd. But there's always stories. In this show, the most frustrating, embarrassing thing, strangely, is the pitch pipe. I cannot get it to blow an E, and it drives us all crazy. That's really embarrassing. Gratifying, I mean, there are so many, but not to be cheesy, but it is really gratifying getting to sing 4-part harmony with 4 strong women singers. It really is. You don't get to do that very often, so that's awesome.
It's pretty awesome when you get to make such great friends in a contract. I feel like I'm performing with my best friends, so that's pretty nice. Cheesy too, I guess. Most embarrassing, obviously, costume malfunctions. These girls know I've had many. You know, anything from the straps kind of falling down and having to deal with that in front of an audience can be pretty embarrassing. I've also been hit in the head by certain flying set pieces that have left me concussed and having to be carried off, and then throwing up on my dance partner, which is awkward.
So. Wow.
Not in the show.
In the wing.
In the wing. And the gratifying, well, anytime there's an audience member that reacts to your performance, whether good or bad, it means they're listening. And for me, that's my job done. And today, this woman that we had chosen as one of our characters, Miss McPherson, stood up and gave me a hug. In my number, which wasn't scripted or planned, and it felt pretty good.
Well, thanks for reminding me, because one of the questions I didn't write down was, have you ever had a situation where one of your, I don't want to blow the surprise for anybody, but have you ever had a situation where one of your Mr. Lees just did not work out?
Not specific. We haven't yet. Some of them look like they're going to hit us or die a little bit, they'd rather be doing anything, but I think people who choose to sit in the front should be prepared that something may at any point happen to them, whether it's something accidentally flying off the stage into their drink or them becoming part of the show.
It's kind of like being at a stand-up comedy show. If you're in the front row, fair game.
Even if they're a little, a little apprehensive at first, we do manage to get them to come around. And by the second act, we usually have them on our side. And that's been our experience so far. So.
Well, the night I attended, the gentleman was very, very accommodating and had you could tell he was having as much fun as everybody else was. So looking through the playbill, you guys have all got some incredible credits. Is there anything in particular you'd like to comment on, or anything that you might want to talk a little bit about from where you've been prior to here at Stage West?
I mean, one interesting thing about me that I know some other people have talked about is that I've done this show before. I believe, to my knowledge, it was even the Canadian premiere of the show in Thousand Island Playhouse in Ontario, but I was BJ. So it's interesting. It's been interesting to approach this show with a different team and play a different game. It's been very fun.
I think it's written in my bio, but last season, award-winning playwright, who is a very dear friend of mine, Stuart Lemoyne, he wrote me into the title role of a new piece of work last year, The Scent of Compulsion, and it was crazy because he's been a mentor and an idol, and he's just a fantastic writer. And to come into work every day and see a larger-than-life-size poster of yourself on the side of a building is pretty ridiculous. But the fact that he trusted me to carry a title role in a show was... No words. But that's one of my favorites.
A high watermark.
Yeah. There's something coming up.
Oh yeah. Also in Calgary. Laura just reminded me. I am choreographing and in Hit and Myth's production of Evil Dead. August 14th to September 8th at the Pump House Theater.
Fantastic. Well, that opens the door to my second last question. What is it that all of you have on the go after Stage West runs?
I will be returning back to Edmonton, where I come from, to revive a role that I did at the Mayfield in Buddy the Buddy Holly story.
Excellent.
The next stop for me is Neptune Theatre in Halifax, and I'm playing the beggar woman in Sweeney Todd.
Excellent.
Well, I'm heading home to Stratford, Ontario, and I'm planning my wedding.
Yay!
So we're taking a little time out.
Wonderful. Well, I gotta thank you all so much. As I say, I know that this is in between two shows here, and I appreciate so much. And best of luck with this run and your future efforts.
Thank you so much. Thank you.